Greetings and assalamu alaikum everyone. Hope you all are doing great and welcome to another video. In this video I'm going to show you the implementation of CloudWatch and CloudWatch agent, but first we have to cover its theory, what actually CloudWatch is and why we use it. Okay, so AWS CloudWatch is a native tool of AWS which is used for monitoring purpose. And as you can see, it is a monitoring service provided by AWS that helps you keep an eye on the performance and health of your resources. Resources like EC2 instance, database, or any other AWS service. It can monitor and detect any unusual activity, and it can inform you. It will help inform you in the form of alarms. Okay. So it basically collects and show you the important information such as CPU usage. It basically collects and shows you the important information like CPU usage, network traffic, or system logs. Okay, and after collecting the logs, you can simplify it and view it in the form of dashboard. Okay, so in the last, I will also configure the dashboard as well. Okay, so this is the short demo of AWS CloudWatch. Okay. But what actually CloudWatch agent is? Basically, it is a small program or a software that we install on EC2 server or any other on-premises server. If we want the detailed monitoring of that specific or particular resource, like for example, if I have my own private server and if I want to get its log and want to watch its memory and CPU utilization on AWS, so I can use and install and configure CloudWatch agent. Okay, so in CloudWatch agent, basically it provides additional metrics information like memory usage and disk space and application logs. Okay, in CloudWatch we don't have memory usage, that's why we prefer to use CloudWatch agent and install CloudWatch agent on that specific or multiple resources or servers so that you can you see and detect its memory usage. Okay, so the agenda for today's video is to install CloudWatch agent on both Windows and Linux server. Okay, so for this video I will be specifically focusing on Windows server right now. For Linux server I will make a separate video, and so stay tuned for that. And I will configure the CloudWatch agent on Linux server on separate video. Okay, so let's jump into AWS console and let's create a new server. Okay, so right now I am inside the AWS console and I have created already a CloudWatch agent server. So let's try to access this server and I will show you how to configure and install CloudWatch agent. Okay everyone, I would like to add one thing that I forgot, and as an important note that we have to first create an IAM role and attach it to the designated server. What designated server means that in that specific server we are using and configuring the CloudWatch agent. Okay, so first of all let me just show you the IAM role first of all, then I will try to access that specific server and install the CloudWatch agent, then I will show you the rest of the steps and configuration. Okay, so I have already created a role, and inside role I have given some policies like EC2 role for SSM and CloudWatch agent server policy. These two policies are more than enough for CloudWatch agent role. Okay, so once I have created this role, and go back to your instance, and we have to attach the IAM role to this server. Okay, so for that go to actions, security, and modify IAM role, and type CW agent. I have created a custom role and select this role and update IAM role. So once you attach this role, so it will communicate, this server will communicate with CloudWatch. Okay, so that's the main purpose of using IAM role. Okay, the purpose of IAM role is to communicate between services of AWS, like communication between EC2 to S3 or EC2 to CloudWatch or any other service that you want to consider it. Okay, so Right now I am inside the server. Okay, and let's open the Edge browser. And right now I am typing the command. Okay, so right now I'm inside the Microsoft Edge browser. You can use any browser. And let me just type and paste the command here. Okay, I will provide this link in video description, so you can download this MSI file. Okay, as you can see that it is downloading and installing CloudWatch Agent file. Okay, once it downloads, I will show you the rest of these configuration. Okay, so right now I'm in download section, and as you can see that the MSI installer file has been downloaded. And let's just download this file and install the CloudWatch Agent. Okay, once you double click this file, so it automatically downloads the configuration file. Okay, so for that, go to your this PC server, then C drive, program files. Let me just zoom in further so that you guys can see it clearly. And go to Amazon folder. And right here, as you can see, we have Amazon CloudWatch Agent folder. Okay, click on this folder and you will see some different files. We have JSON file, we have application file, we have a jar file, and we have some different extension files. So in this case, we have to use the configuration wizard file. Okay, so right click on it and open. Okay, so it shows you the configuration in the form of CLI. This is basically CMD window, and it is asking some options. Okay, so just focus on the options that I'm telling you in this video. So first of all, select the second option. Okay, as this is the Windows EC2 server, we have to choose second option. Okay, click on second option. Okay, it is asking either on EC2 or on premises. Obviously, we are configuring this on EC2, so the default choice will be first option. So do we want to turn on states the daemon? Basically, back in the backend, it runs its own states the daemon server. So you can use yes. And it runs on port 8125. Yes. And you can use any option like collect interval for states the daemon. And aggregation interval for metrics, I'm selecting the fourth option, which is 60 seconds. And it is asking, do you have any existing CloudWatch agent, log agent configuration file? So I don't have right now, so I'm selecting the second option. And it is asking to monitor any host metrics like CPU, memory. I'm saying yes. Yes. And it is asking for the dimension like image ID, instance ID, instance type, auto scaling group name. So I'm saying yes. Yes. And for high resolution collection of metrics, I'm going with the fourth option, which is 60 seconds. And for default metrics, I'm going with the standard option. Okay, you can go with this basic, standard, or advanced option. But for now, I'm selecting second option, which is standard. Okay. As you can see, basically, it has generated some JSON file output. This file is very important, so make sure that you should not delete or make some any changes. If there is a requirement to change this file, you can change it later on. But for now, this file is very important, and make sure that you should not delete this file. Otherwise, your CloudWatch agent will not work. Okay. And it is asking that, are you satisfied with the above configuration? I am saying yes. And I am leaving the rest of the option. One more option I have seen right now, which is asking for log group class. You can either consider standard or infrequent access. So I am selecting standard option. And XML format. Do you want to store Windows event to CloudWatch agent? So I'm saying, okay, I'm going with the first option as first option. Yes, this is the important question, that how many days do you want to store your logs? So we have option called log group retention in days. So for demo purpose, I am selecting option number 6, which is 14 days. So this means that I want to keep and store the logs of 14 days. After 15 days start, it will start from second day till 15 day. Okay, so I'm selecting 6 option. Okay, so it is asking me to store the configuration file in SSM parameter store. Basically, we have another service called SSM System Manager in AWS. So I will cover this topic in future. But for right now, I am selecting second option, which is no, because I don't want to store this configuration file in SSM parameter store. Okay. Press enter to exit. Your configuration file and installation of CloudWatch agent has been done. Okay, guys, once the CLI windows closed, and you can see that it has generated config.json file. And for this, you need to run with the help of PowerShell or any other CLI based like CMD or PowerShell. Okay, so for that, let me just show you the command. But first, let me just open PowerShell here. And let me just type the command. I will provide this command in video description. Okay. Paste anyway. Okay, wait. I mistakenly paste the wrong command here. So I have pasted the correct command here. And let's just type enter and see if this thing works or not. Okay. So as you can see, that Amazon CloudWatch agent has been started, as you can see in the PowerShell window output. Okay, so how to verify whether the CloudWatch agent is running or not? We have two options. So for that, let's just go to services.msc. Okay, so as you can see, after opening the services.msc, you can see the Amazon CloudWatch agent is running. Okay. Now from AWS console, let's just verify it. Okay. Now I'm back in AWS console, and let's just open the CloudWatch management console, and let's just create and see if we are able to see the metrics or not. As you can see right here, that we have a custom namespace. The concept of namespace is that you can consider it as a separate repository or as a separate folder, okay, where it contains the n number of resources, n number of metrics and other configuration related files. Okay, so if you go to CW agent, and let's suppose if I want to select the instance ID, so it will provide me some insight. Okay, let's just create a dashboard and go to all metrics option right here, as you can see, and CW agent, and go to instance ID, and paste your instance ID. Okay, how we get instance ID? So I have copied this instance ID from EC2 console and paste it here, and then enter. So you will see some metrics with accordance to instance ID, and it automatically represents the instance name as well, which is CloudWatch agent server in this case. Okay, so I am selecting memory committed bytes, and let me just show you that I have already mentioned in the video that I will create a dashboard. Okay, so let's just create a dashboard. I am giving name as memory usage dashboard. Once you create a dashboard, we have to select the widget configuration, either line, number, stack area. We have different types of metrics. Okay, so I am going with the number option. Click on next. As you can see, we have a different namespace. Go to CW agent, instance ID, paste your instance ID right here, and you can select the memory committed bytes and create widget. Once you create widget, as you can see that it is showing you the memory percentage in bytes, and click on save. So let's just go back to the dashboard, and you will see the 45.4% bytes as a memory usage. Okay, let me just do one more thing. Right now I am inside the server, and let's just install the stress testing. Okay, so for Windows we have a software called Heavy Load, and I am downloading and installing this, and let's just use this as a stress utility test and see if this thing works or not. Okay, while I'm installing it and running it, I will show you the rest of the results. Okay, so I have installed the Heavy Load application, and let's just click on display button, and it will start the rendering process. Basically it has its own testing phase. It provides some additional stress based testing, and let's just go back to CloudWatch and expand this window, and let's wait for 1 minute. Okay, as you can see that the number has been increased from 45 to 50, and let's just wait for 5 minutes more. Okay, as you can see that the number has been increased from 43 to 57 or the last value, and let's just say right now the result has been jumped from 57 to 88.6%, and as you can see that the stress testing is now indicating its own result, and you will see that it is showing the 88.6%. So that's how you can start stress testing and monitor your CPU usage or memory usage of your EC2 instance. Okay, so that's how you can create a dashboard and monitor your EC2 instance or any other resources where you have installed the CloudWatch agent. Okay, so that's the entire video of configuring CloudWatch agent and show you the stress utilities testing. And let's just stop this one, and I will see you in the next video, and I will show you this same procedure on Linux one. Okay, so stay tuned for that, and have a good day, and take care of yourself and your loved ones. Okay, Allah Hafiz.